maybe central banks, maybe inflation isn't the number one objective.
In renewables, etc.
The first factor that, in my opinion, led to this inflationary spiral that we're seeing in 2021 was this unprecedented level of support that was given by the governments in terms of fiscal, and then a very huge stimulus that was given also by monetary authorities when it unleashed itself in 2021. And probably one of the major factors that we saw was also this, we were looking at the numbers and that it was estimated by OECD that at least 1 to 1.5% of the inflation was due to this expansion of prices for freight.
One of the main goals of stimulus is, of course, generate sufficient productivity. It seems as though that you mentioned that the productivity existed much more in the tech.
So you need to look at two points, I think, which are critical. One point is the households, and the other point are the firms.
You talked about the inflation history in the U.S., 70s, and do know what to do. The question is if they can do it or not. 70s, you know, it was kind of hard to leave Nixon and others. So do you see a risk?
One thing that COVID told us is to be humble about predictions about germs, is to what extent inflation expectations are anchored in the sense that people believe. If you're thinking about the first big episodes of inflation following the First World War, and the government is maintained, then I think this will continue. Expectations are anchored.
This is something which is unexpected, and people are having to try and
excess demand over supply. So that's one thing.
Look like in the upcoming months and over the next years. And now inflation in the US is 5.4%. In Germany, it's 3.4%.